Last night I dreamed that I was a child out where the pines grow wild and tall. I was trying to make it home through the forest before the darkness falls. I heard the wind rustling through the trees, and ghostly voices rose from the fields. I ran with my heart pounding down that broken path with the devil snapping at my heels. I broke through the trees and there in the night, my father's house stood shining hard and bright. The branches and brambles tore my clothes and scratched my arms, but I ran till I fell, shaking in his arms. I awoke and I imagined the hard things that pulled us apart. Would never again tear us from each other's hearts. I got dressed to his house. I did run from out on the road. I could see its windows shining in light. Well, I walked up the steps and I stood on the porch, and a woman I didn't recognize, she came and spoke to me through a chain door. Well, I told her my story and who I'd come for. She said, "I'm sorry, son, but no one by that name lives here anymore." Well, now those whose love we wanted but didn't get, we emulate them. It's the only way we have in our power to get the closeness and the love that we needed and desired. So when I was a young man and looking for a voice to meld with mine, to sing my songs and to tell my stories, well, I chose my father's voice because there was something sacred in it to me. And when I went looking for something to wear, I put on a factory worker's clothes because they were my dad's clothes. And all we know about manhood is what we have seen and what we have learned from our fathers. And my father was my hero and my greatest foe. Not long after he died, I have this dream. I'm on stage, I'm in front of thousands of people, and my dad's back from the dead, and he's sitting in the audience, and suddenly I'm kneeling next to him in the aisle. And for a moment, we both watch the man on fire on stage. And then to my dad, who for years he sat at the kitchen table, unreachable. And what I was too young and I was too stupid to understand was his depression. Well, I kneel next to him in the aisle, and I brush his forearm. And I say, "Look, Dad, that guy on stage. And that's how I see you. My Father's house shines hard and bright. Stands like a beacon, calling me in the night. Calling and calling, so cold and alone. Shining across this dark highway, where our sins lie unatoned.